I'll be What were you doing for 4 hours at the police station this afternoon talking to an officer Eddie Southern?
What were you doing for 4 hours at the police station this afternoon talking to Officer Eddie Southern? Who?
One of my boys who talked to the cops, and my gut tells me it was you, Ernie.
Wasn't me, boss. It was Joey.
I wouldn't tell on you, boss. I love you.
TJ?
What?
Popular?
Me? I would give my life for you. I didn't tell on you.
So it wasn't any of you, huh? Well, I guess I just have to go. My God, then!
No, boss! Please, no!
Too late!
I saw nothing. Just a whole mess of nothing. I was coming here to thank you for this stunning blue fur, and it goes with everything. Look, Ernie's taking a little nap.
Dolores, baby.
Shh, we mustn't wake Ernie. I'll just tiptoe out here and see what my fur goes with. Again, it's all nothing, nothing.
Boss, what do we do?
Bring her back in. I think it's time we have a little sauce.
As in Cartier's. I do know you. High school.
Yeah, that was me.
You had a crush on me.
Yeah, that was me.
I come around and you get so nervous you start to sweat.
Wait, no, that wasn't me.
I called you Sweaty Eddie.
Look, I'd appreciate if you didn't call.
I'll go check on Ernie, Sweaty Eddie.
Look, Dolores. Curtis Jackson needs to be put away. We've been working on this case for over a year. If you saw Ernie get killed, you need protection. We need to hide you.
Hide me? How are you gonna hide me? How are you gonna hide all this?
Dolores, Curtis will kill you. Here's a picture of the last guy we talked.
What's left of him?
You gotta hide me.
We need a place he's never been to look. And I got the perfect place. Let's go.
Donation.
I see. Lord, if this is a test, I cannot fail with you by my side. May she be of faith. Modesty.
Whoa, would you look at this place? Holy cow.
choir of angels. Drop me out if you didn't hear me, Lord. Faith of modesty.
My superior? This is Dolores.
Dolores Van Cartier, as in Cartier's.
thank you, Mother Superior, for letting her hide here for the month.
A month? This is the perfect place?
Yeah, now you stay here, hide in this coffin, and be inconspicuous.
Once here, I must urge you to reconsider.
Mother Superior, you took a vow of charity.
I take it back.
Mother Superior?
Very well then. Welcome to Queen of Angels.
Thank you.
Come, Officer Souther, let us make reparations.
Well, yes. Okay. Okay. Great acoustics. I like the reverb. Hey, I just want to say, I really dig what you nuns are doing. I mean, at the end of The Sound of Music, when you sisters stole the Nazis' car parts so the singing children could get away? I mean, that's good stuff. Thank you. Now, while here, you shall behave enough. Do you know how a nun behaves? Hey, I went to Catholic school as a kid. The benefits of which are quite apparent. Now, do you pray, child? Well, one time I saw Donna Summer. She was wearing a white fox fur and had a white sequin dress. And I said to myself, Lord, I wish I had that dress. Does that count as a prayer? No. The material world has no value here. This is a different world you enter now. Behind these walls, we live a life of adoration and grace. This is a sanctuary. Outside, life's a mess. No spirit, spirit any longer. There's no longer and stronger and longer. People have amused themselves to death. Outside, all this sin. And I won't have the outside coming in. Trust me, it's a battle you won't win. Rightly, dear, you haven't got a prayer. But here within these walls, things are filled with grace. God is his place. His wisdom still is baptized. You must wear this habit.
No way!
Pardon me?
I mean, maybe I can dress it up a little.
We've worn that since the 14th century. It does not cry out for accessories.
But if I put this dress on, I would just drop dead.
Well then, we have a plan.
Just be who.
for us by Sister Mary Celeste and Sister Mary Irene.
Hey, everybody!
Sisters! Allow me to introduce you to our newest member, Sister Mary Clarence. She's visiting us from a more progressive order.
Wow. You're young.
I'm a postulant.
Mary Clarence, will you join us, please? Bless you. This way. Bless you. Right here. Bless you.
Sit down!
I'm Sister Mary Lazarus. This is Sister Mary Martin of Tours. She's in her own little world. Does the smoke change colors? Do we have a new pope?
Focus! We're at Christmas dinner with the new nun.
Sister Mary Clarence, my name is Mary Patrick, and I just wanted to say welcome to Queen of Angels, and I was wondering if you would lead us into prayer?
I shall pray with Mary Clarence. She has taken a vow of modesty and eschews all attention. Let's pray. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy
Smokes.
Ghost.
Our
Father, who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name.
Hallowed
be thy name.
Thy kingdom for a horse and yea. Though I walk through the valley of the shadow of no food, I shall fear no hunger. We want you to give us this day our daily bread, and to the Republic for which it stands. And by the power invested in me, I pronounce us ready to eat at last. Eat at last. Thank God Almighty. Eat at last.
Everyone's gone now. Let's forget about the fast.
thing.
A fast can bring you an awareness of life that could do you some good.
Listen, I don't need you to lecture me on my life, okay? That wasn't part of the deal, you lecturing me. My life is great.
Really?
In a city with over 1 million people, you don't have a single friend to take you in.
A time where success in the music industry is blossoming, you can't get a job. And when your boyfriend finds out what you have done, he will try to kill you. God has sent you here for a reason. Take the hint. I'm limiting your activities to a single task. You're a musician, true?
Yes.
And you're comfortable working with other musicians, true?
Yes.
You can work with a choir.
Are they good?
There are no words.
That's nice. See what happens when we talk. It's a beautiful day.
Raise your voice, lift it.
getting too winded.
Winded? Stand back, sister.
Thank you.
also defined in the offering plate. Sweet, keep on sending love to the man of love.
Start to fly.
Who am I kidding? I'll always be sweaty at you to her.
But before it's my time to die, I will be that guy someday. Maybe someday.
Here's the church, here's the steeple. Open the doors, they ain't no people. As of tomorrow, Sister Mary Lazarus resumes her leadership of the choir. This is non-negotiable.
Take me
to heaven. My superior, bless me, Father, for I have sinned. Yes, yes, I'm sure you have. That's fine. People are hearing this music and coming off the streets. To throw money into the collection, this, it's a success.
It is?
Yes, and that's not all. The people interested in buying the church are now using the money they're going to use to purchase it to keep our services going. How much longer will Sister Mary plan to be with us?
I've spoken with Officer Southern about transferring her to our Reading Diocese.
Oh no, I do hope she can stay. I adore this music, Reverend Mother. Sister Mary Clarence is a godsend. You are a visionary.
You are a visionary. I am a godsend.
I can hear you smiling.
God has sent me here for a reason. Take the hint. One hymn per service. And that doesn't include encores.
People, your vibrations are beautiful. I gotta tell you, this is a really big tabernacle. And you guys are filling it with a lot of love right now. Our sisters have worked out a nutty little number of tree figures. Really, really special. But first, our restoration fund. Let's check the tote boards. It's all about the love and the giving. You people are marvelous. Give yourselves a round of applause. Now in the name of the Father, the Son, and you know who, I give you Sister Mary Clarence and her old Queen of Angel Singers. Lay it on, sisters.
Spread the news. It's time to rock the pew. We got the Sunday morning fever.
Sisters,
Sweet lady in the long black Thank you.
with Officer Southern.
He's taking you away.
Who's Dolores?
Patrol cars have blocked off Arch Street. It's time to get your things, Dolores.
Why'd you call her Dolores?
I believe the sisters need to hear this from you.
Sisters,
I have something to tell you. I'm not really a nun.
I'm not really a Catholic.
You see, I was dating a very bad man, and I saw him murder someone. And I'm going to court to say that. But first, I have to hide from him. Here.
So you lied to us?
I'm sorry. You should leave now.
For ye shall step out with joy and be led forth with peace. The mountains and the hills shall break before you into singing, and the trees of the field shall clap their hands.
Yeah. Isaiah 55:12. Come, sisters. We must leave Dolores so she can pack her things before Officer Southern arrives.
Well, come on now. We have done the Lord's work. We have helped the person in her time of need. Now, let's return to our lives as God has planned it.
Dolores?
Ooh, you scared me. Tomorrow is the biggest day of our lives.
How can you leave us now?
I gotta think about my own life.
Then I want to go with you.
What?
I want to go with you. The others, they all know that this is where they belong. They've all received their calling, but maybe this life isn't for me. Or maybe it is. I don't know.
Honey, I'm not a priest.
I know,
but you're my friend, and I always know what I'm missing.
That you are never alone.
don't need a spotlight. I don't need a crowd. I don't need the great wide world to shout my name out loud. Don't need fame or fortune, nice as those things are. I've got all I need to feel like that. I've got my sisters by my side. I've got my sisters' love and pride. And with my sisters here, I have no fear. I'm right where I should be. And with my sisters standing strong, I'm on the stage where I belong.
Most importantly, your very presence here puts our entire community at risk. So I must ask you to leave, for their sake.
No.
This will not concern you.
Dolores is one of us. She stays and we all stand with her.
Mary Roberts!
What's that? It's Curtis! He found me! Sisters, let's go!
Get out of here, Mary Robert.
Dolores, you're causing me all kinds of problems. Look at you in that getup, walking around pretending to be a nun. Sure, Chuck. You sure ain't no nun.
Yes, she is. She is a sister. Sister Mary Clarence, as true a sister as this common has ever known.
Well then, Sister Mary Clarence, time for your last rites, right?
Take me to heaven. Take me to paradise.
Receive my humble prayer. The faith that I bear, accept my sacrifice.
Without anyone saying a word. Perhaps one day you will know that that is God. Or perhaps one day you will know that that is just being human. Or perhaps one day we will know that it is both and they are the same thing. Nothing matters more than love. Friendship and affection, real connection. It's a gift from above. Every song that we sing, every prayer that we pray, makes a bond in a way that's profound.
Woo!
clapping my hands. I'm supposed to say stuff, but I can't move my face because I've been smiling for 60 straight minutes. Thank you. Tradition here at CSA, we love to share a talk back, a reflection. I know, right? We love to be able to reflect on what we've done and share some of our thoughts about the process. Before we get to that, we have one more big, big thank you. Cast, could we please give it up for the hardest working crew in the show? With any crew, let alone a crew comprised entirely of eighth graders that is this organized and dedicated and on top of every little detail. I mean, listen, this is a hard show to pull off. A lot of moving parts, a lot of costumes, and they did it with so much grace and so much integrity and care. So thank you, our crew. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. So our talk back, we always ask the same three questions. We ask, what did you learn about yourself? What did you learn about working with others? And what did you learn about creativity and the creative process, making theater? And you know that Ms. Q is getting old when she needs both notes and the glasses to read the notes. But I've written down the names of the folks that didn't get to share on other nights and wanted to share tonight. So our first respondents for our first question are going to be Abigail, Diego, and Maggie for what did you learn about yourselves?
Hi, my name's Abigail and I'm in eighth grade. And I learned that I can really like team build. Like when dancing, you have to like think about what your teammates like, oh, how are we gonna do this? And I really learned how to like have patience and team build, and also like, I like dancing. I learned that, like, I could just dance and smile without having to think about smiling.
Hi, I'm Diego, I'm in sixth grade. And what I learned about myself is that I can do hard things, and I think just about everyone learned this, because being in a musical is hard. You have to memorize, and then you have to go on stage and sing and dance and act and smile and smile and smile and smile. But, and sometimes there are complications that get in the way with that. Sometimes there are mistakes, sometimes there are problems, but you just have to keep going because that's all you have to do.
Hi, my name is Maggie. I'm in eighth grade. And one thing I learned during this is that everyone is just really like reliable. I can't think of one person that I wouldn't be able to count on. I know everyone there would be there for me and for everyone else, so.
Thanks so much, y'all. So for our second question about what have you learned about working with other people, we're gonna hear from Nora, May, Hazel, Alexi, and Amelia. So I'm gonna help you all sort that out.
Hello, my name is Nora, and I'm in the eighth grade. And one thing I learned about working with others is that I'm gonna miss you guys so much.
Hi, my name is May, I'm in the 7th grade. And so I learned that 6th, 7th, and 8th graders are equally talented in their own way.
Hi, I'm Hazel and I'm in 7th grade. What I learned about working with others is I have to be really patient. And I also learned I'm gonna miss the eighth graders that are going off to high school.
Hello, my name is Alexi and I'm in seventh grade. What I have learned with working with others is that you have to trust yourself and you have to trust other people around you. And like coming into this, I thought it was like just, you know, a musical, but then it's like a whole group of people you get to work with and you get to meet new people, you get to experience all this bitter sweetness. Like I've seen people crying. And but you know, this is a big family.
Hi, I'm Amelia and I'm in the seventh grade. And what I learned about working with other people in this process is it is very bittersweet because there are you're all friends, but then someone might say something to you that you might find hurtful, but you're still friends.
Third question, Rocco starting us off. Rocco, Rainer, Ava, Kaylee.
Hi, my name's Rocco, I'm in eighth grade. Process is that no matter how many thousands of hours you pour in, something's bound to go wrong, and you just have to go. Woo!
Hi, my name is Rainer. I'm in eighth grade. And what I learned about theater as an art form is that it's not just memorizing lines and being backstage. It's also,
I'm so sorry. Oh my God, don't cry.
It's meeting people that inspire you, and I'm so sorry. I know I'm dressed all in black right now and really sweaty because I was backstage, but this is my first and last year at CSA, and I really just want to thank the I really want to thank this school and this musical especially because it really made me realize that I want to pursue acting in my life, and yeah.
Cherish the moments that you have.
Because the more that you enjoy the moments, then the greater the outcome will be, and the more heartfelt and amazing that the outcome will be. So yeah.
Rely on everyone around you, and you have to rely on your teammates
even if they're like, even if you're fighting, even if you're like arguing about something, it's all about community. It's all about like communal work, you know.
Hi, I'm Kaylee. I'm in the eighth grade. What I learned about theater is that, like, at first, I had no interest in theater. Like, I remember I came here last year, like, to the musical, and I auditioned as a joke. I told Miss Q, I remember this. I told Miss Q, I said, please do not put me on stage. I do not want to be on stage. I don't want people to see me. I'm embarrassed. I hate cameras. But I woke up next morning, and I got one of the biggest lead roles, and I was on the top of the list, and I was so scared, but I did it, and I remember the first day of rehearsals, I came, I was like, these people are so weird. Like, I'm so awkward. Like, how? I don't know none of these people. Like I know my grade, my friends, but I don't know none of these people. And when I got to know them, they became such an important part of my life. And every teacher agreed on me that I changed because of musical. I changed for the better. And I've also known people that thought, like, I know Salik as well. He was like, I'm not going to join musicals. And he joined this year. And look what happened. He was amazing. And so from the other side, brings people together, and it's like, I know people that are like, oh, I'm never gonna do this, that's so embarrassing, why would I go on stage and act like that? And they come here, and then they realize that they're like, oh, this is not my family, I'm not related to any of you guys. But at the end, like the last show, they realize that these people are really important to them, and that these people build a community, a family, and we're all together in this, and if one person messes up, we all have their back, so it's really important to them.
When I first auditioned to be in this musical, I didn't really want to be a part of it. I want to be a part of crew. But Miss Q and Ava had pushed me to actually audition for it because it might be a thing that I wanted to do for the first time, so I did it. And when I woke up the next day, kind of what Keely said, I realized that I had gotten one of the lead roles. And at first I was worried and I was scared and I didn't know what to do, but I just went along with it. And I wasn't really used to that type of environment, working with other people and making like a performance. And when I started it, I actually started to enjoy it, and I started to persevere through the challenges that were going through my personal life, and coming to the musical kind of like uplifted my soul. And each performance that I have done in the past 2 days, it has brought me more and more joy to where I am now, leaving as an eighth grader to go to a performing arts high school.
And thank you for joining our cast. Thanks to all of you all. Parents, I'm sorry that all of your children have been reduced to sobbing messes. Sorry, not sorry. Before I let you go, I have some thank yous. In the interest of time, I'm going to ask for some help here. And I'm going to share all my thank yous all at once. And then I'm going to ask my crew to do one last heroic effort to get these flowers where they belong. Can y'all do that for me?
Yes,
so
yes.
Thank you. Great. Hang on just a second. Let's do this properly. All right. So, great. Will you, Eli, pass that down to Isaac? And you all hang on to this. Great. So here's how this is going to go. I would like to thank, first and foremost, the grown-ups that I have had the privilege of working with.
CSA is an incredible community. This is all possible because we are united in our shared mission to use art as a pathway to connection, to academic learning, to self and social learning, to awareness of the world around us. This show is a great example of that. As Nora said, this is a show about raising our voices, and we are in a historic moment where young people's voices have never been more important. So I'm so, so proud to work in this community, and especially to work alongside colleagues who, all right, y'all gotta just pipe down for a second. Raise your voice, but you know, keep it together. I'm so, so proud to work alongside colleagues who really share that mission with me. So I wanna make some acknowledgements, and it's gonna be really hard, but you gotta just like wait to clap, okay? Because otherwise we're gonna be here all night. All right, so I wanna first and foremost thank new colleagues, Brandon and Christina, for their work with vocal coaching and choreography. My stalwart and beloved colleagues, Anna and Michael, for choreography and backstage coordination. Caitlin for coming through always. Backstage, whatever we need, she's always there. Miss Erin, my absolute love. We are getting misty-eyed today thinking about how many years it's been. Those years have flown. I love you. Thank you so much. My forever partner in crime, of course, Dr. Jeffrey Corpus, my co-founder, all of the parents who have helped out backstage. There are too many to name. They're all in the program, especially Mirna and Asaka and Anne. Carla, who comes back to house manage for us every year, even though her child graduated in 2018 and is now a freshman at Temple University studying theater, and she's still coming back to house manage every year. And she's right there. Oh my God, I can't. And so. Week and a half straight, our ushers. Now I'm going to my kiddos, right? I really, really want to acknowledge all of our eighth graders, all of them on crew and cast. So my eighth graders, please stand. You're gonna receive flowers from the crew. If I call your name, you're gonna receive flowers from the crew. Indigo and Indy and Michaela, I'm good. And then Marco and Clara and Maggie and TJ, who was also a dancer and a crew member.
Smiling. It's like both.
Unbelievable.